Time now for an in-depth look at the market news on this Friday, and for that I'm joined on the line by Mr. Daniel Yu, Global Strategist at Yuanta Securities. Mr. Yu, good afternoon. Good to have you back on.
Good afternoon.
Well, stocks on Wall Street closed higher overnight, though U.S. GDP came in below expectations. There were other factors, though, like a pickup in production, good earnings from some companies, although not Amazon for one. What's the story in the global markets?
Yes, if you look at the overall economic growth numbers, it came in much below expectation. It showed about annualized 6.5% on quarter of second quarter versus market forecast of about 8.5%. Clearly, there's some areas that put some doubts about the economic recoveries, particularly on the labor market, that the labor market recovery is not as strong as hoped. In any case, though, personal consumption expenditures, namely services, are all growing at around 12% territories. Yes, an economy is improving. And as you said, the overall earnings numbers coming from various other companies are showing a fairly good numbers. Of course, there are uncertainty about this market where Amazon is trading at significantly lower on the aftermarket because of the, not the earnings of second quarter, but the, looking into the future, there's guidance were coming in much below the expectations, and that's causing the current certain uncertainties. But in any case, overall earnings numbers for the second quarter are showing very strong, and that's why U.S. market did okay yesterday. It did go up by about 0.4% for Dow Jones, and S&P was up about 0.4%, and NASDAQ was up about 0.1%, and small cap was up by about 0.7%. But in any case, though, this week so far had been fairly volatile week where there's been concern about the China impact of regulatory environment, and then recently with economic growth numbers coming in below expectation, uncertainty is definitely lingering, and that has resulted into most of the other markets showing declining trend today, post the futures market showing quite a weakness due to some of these economic numbers coming through from U.S.
Well, ahead of that, Korean stocks closed lower today, a fairly significant decline. Only a very few sectors making gains today. Retail investors, though, apparently seeing a chance to buy. Tell us about the domestic market.
Yes, Korean market did quite a bit of weak performance. KOSPI was down by 1.2%. KOSDAQ was also down by 1.2%. The large cap also was down by about 1.3%. Clearly, this is due to foreign investors continue to be a net seller. They sold about 664 billion won worth of equities, and institutions sold about 573 billion, while the only net buyer was the retail investors, buying 1.2 trillion won worth of equities. Now, so South Korea's government and finance minister, Vice Finance Minister Lee, is saying that Fed meetings are not going to be impacting that significantly for Korea. But continuously, there's uncertainty regarding the COVID-19 Delta variant to the domestic consumption numbers. So therefore, government will be watching this very keenly. And market volatility might be something that is installed for the time being. But if you look at the overall market, Korean market since the COVID-19, every month it showed positive performance for all last 13 months or so. Now, this is the only month that the number of June that showed quite a bit of July that showed a declining YOY. Or I guess the quarter on quarter or month on month. So these numbers are saying that we need some kind of breather for Korean market. Korean market did very well from the bottom to top, where it has risen more than 100% plus. It needed some kind of some corrections for the time being because of the global market showing some corrections. However, though, if you look at it on a longer term basis, we think the fundamental for Korea is very strong right now. There's the uncertainty about the dollars and U.S. exchange rate to the Korean won, and Korean won has been continued to be a depreciating environment, and that resulted into foreign net selling so far. However, though, we think that Korean won is at the high end of the trading range, where it hit well above 1150 territories. We think that it's not going to depreciate further, so therefore, after this July month, we think that foreign investors are not going to be the major net seller. And therefore, we are looking at probably possibility of recovery happening in August based on the very strong economy numbers and very strong earnings growth number.
Well, we'll continue to watch that, of course. And final question, Mr. Yu, look at some more data here in Korea. Production rising again last month, notably in semiconductors, retail sales up too. Still hanging over all of that is the fourth wave of the pandemic. Help us go through this data from June.
Sure. If you look at the industrial productions and retail sales, and all these numbers are showing that reasonable growth numbers. If you look at, first of all, the retail sales, it has grew by about 1.6% year-on-year in June of 2021. That's a slightly less than a very strong number of 3.1% jump that we saw in the previous month. But in any case, it has been a fifth straight month of gains on retail trade. Now, in terms of the industrial output production side, the growth number came in at very strong. It grew by 11.9% year-on-year in June of 2021, following the revised number of 14.9% gain in the previous month. In any case, there is continuation of two-digit growth numbers happening on the industrial production numbers. As for the construction output, it actually decreased by 3.1% from year earlier in June of 2021, following the revised 6.9% gain in the previous month. Obviously, there is uncertainty regarding the real estate market, and that has resulted into construction output being relatively less. In any case, if you look at export numbers, domestic consumption numbers, retail sales numbers, all indicating that Korea is in a good position, that the economy is growing at a fairly reasonable pace. If you look at the economic growth numbers, in quarter of June, it grew by about 0.7% on quarter-on-quarter basis. And that seems to be continued reasonably good number. Of course, there's uncertainty regarding what's happening to the COVID-19 variant that might result into weaker domestic consumption numbers. However, though, export numbers should be remaining very strong, with the U.S. consumption retail sales numbers being strong, as well as Chinese retail sales numbers being strong.
All right, Mr. Yu, we'll have to leave it there for today. Thank you, as always, for your insights. We always appreciate it. And have a great weekend.
Thank you. You too.